Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to another tutorial of Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 and 2019. And in this tutorial, we are going to make this optical illusion motion background. So have a look first. That is the first slide, which is repeating the same loop. And on the second slide, it moved left, then moved right, and then stop. Because there is no loop in this animation, and I will tell you why. So in this tutorial, I will not only tell you about how to create this animation, but you will also learn a few basic things which will help you in your future projects. So let's get started. On the first slide, you can see that I have drawn these many of shapes and I have used the insert shape, frame shape. And once you click inside the slide, it will draw a default size 1x1 size frame here, and you can zoom in. And you can also modify this frame from this yellow handler and can adjust the width. You can download my presentation and you can see that which properties I have applied for the formatting of this shape. And let me show you that. Right click on the shape and choose format shape. And under the fill settings, you can see that which setting I have applied to create the frame and to change the formatting. As you can see that I am using the gradient fill. And here I am choosing the type linear with a 45 degree angle, and I am using these colors. You can modify the colors as you want, and you can also see the brightness level. These are the default one, transparency and brightness. Let me close this one. So how to animate when you have so many objects on the same slide? So it will be difficult for you to select a particular shape when you need to apply the animations. So the better way is to use the selection pane along with the animation pane. So I will show you everything from the beginning, and for that I will select the first animation, hold down the shift key and then select the last one and hit the delete key. And before that, let me show you one more thing, that all these frames are very much larger than the slide size. So to check this, you can press Ctrl A to select all the objects, hold down the shift key and move them to the left, and you can see that slide size is smaller than the frame size. Click the undo. So I will delete all these animation and will start from the beginning. And for that, I will select all and hit the delete key. Now I want to apply the animation on the first frame on the slide. So which one will be the first frame? Let me delete this one as well. So this shape 3, which is behind all the object, is our first frame. So when you need to apply an animation which is behind all the other objects on the slide, then what you can do, you can open the selection pane from the home tab by clicking on the select drop down button and can click hide all. Now turn on shape 3, select it and zoom in. Now I want to apply a left motion path to it, and for that I will go to animations, add animation, more motion path. Scroll down and here I will choose left motion path. So I will shorten the path length by holding it from the end position and also holding the shift key, and will drag it back. And when you hold down the shift key while adjusting the motion paths, then the path go in a linear position, in a straight line position. So it will be easier for you to adjust the path. And you can notice on the ruler a red line in the ruler. And I want to drop this part up to 2 inch. So here we have our first animation, and I will modify the properties. And for that, I will set it to play with previous with the duration of 1 second. Hit the enter key. Open the effect option property by right clicking on the effect and choose effect options. Or you can also double click to open the effect option properties. So here I need the smoothness, and that is half of the total duration for both start and end smoothness. And I also want to auto reverse this animation and want to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Hit the OK key. And here we have our first animation. And now I want to duplicate this animation to all the rest of the objects on the slide. And for that, I will take the help of Animation Painter and the selection pane. And you will see that how easily I can apply animation on all the objects. But if you show all of the objects at once, then it will be difficult for you to replicate the same animation on rest of the objects, even if you use the Animation Painter without the help of selection pen. So here is the example, hide all, and I will show the first one which has the animation. Now I will select this object and will double click the animation painter to lock it. Now I will hide this object and will turn on the second one and will click on the second object once, and the same animation will get applied on it. You will see only one animation in the list because you have turned off this shape. If you turn on it, then you will also see the previous animation. So what I will do now, I will, as the animation painter is loaded, so you don't need to worry to click again and again on animation painter. Now you can just turn off this one and turn on the third and then just start clicking. So that is how easy it could be to apply the same animation on many objects using the selection pen and the animation painter. After you have applied the animations to all the objects, then click on show all from the selection pen and zoom out a little bit. Now the last thing is to add the delay timing between these animation effects, and I am adding a 0.05 delay from the second animation and will continue to add a 0.05 delay adding to the next one. For the third one it will be 0.10 and for the fourth one 0.15 and so on. So now let's see the preview, and here we have our optical illusion, and it is repeating in loops until end of the slide, until I click to get to the second slide. So how to create the second slide animation? For that I will replicate the first one by right clicking on it and choose duplicate slide, and let me show you everything from the beginning on the second slide, and let me delete the rest of the animation except the first one, and here I will hide all of them and will show only the first one. Select it and zoom in. Now I want to apply the second motion path to the same object, and for that I will select the object, go to the animations tab, click add animation, more motion path, and this time I will choose right. Hit the OK key. However, you can see the motion path length, I want 2 inch as we did for the left one. Now I will adjust the properties of the second motion path, and for that I will select it, go to the animations tab, set it to play with previous with a duration of 1 second, and then double click on it and choose auto reverse. So as I said in the beginning that we cannot repeat this animation, both of these animation on the second slide, and there is a reason behind it, and let me turn on this until end of the slide and will show you that how it will affect if you repeat the same animation until end of the slide. So here I will add a delay timing for the second animation because we want this frame to move left first, then auto reverse, and then move right, and then again auto reverse. So for the second animation I will add a delay timing according to the first animation total duration. So the duration of the first animation is 1 second, but you are auto reversing this animation, so the total length of this animation will be 2 seconds. So I will select the second animation and will add a delay timing of 2 seconds. Now let's see the preview as you are repeating this animation until end of the slide. So for the first loop it will work fine, but on the second loop it will repeat like this. So that is not what we want here. So here is the thing that Microsoft should also consider, that there is no option in PowerPoint to make a delay between the repeats. Like I want to move this object to the left first, which will take 2 seconds, and then again I want a 2 second delay between the second repeat. Then you can't add a delay between the repeats. So that is why you have to turn off the end of slide option, and for that go to the timings tab and set it to none. Hit the OK key. And you can have only one loop of this animation. Now we will repeat the same steps to copy the same animation to rest of the objects, and for that I will select this one, click the animation painter twice, and then turn off this one, and then start clicking on the second object and repeat the same steps. And finally you have to add a delay timing between the animation sets. And for that click show all and then move to top of the list and here select this third animation, and I would like to add a delay timing for this 1.05. And for the fourth animation, you have to add a delay timing adding to the previous delay timing, and for that you will add it 2.05. and for the third set, you have to apply 0.10 and here 2.10, and you have to repeat these steps to add delay timing between all the animations. And once you add the delay timing, it will look like this. As you can see, in for the last animations, the delay timing is 0.80. You can download this presentation from the link below. And for the last one, 2.80. So when you will see the slideshow, it will look like this, but only with one loop. So when you need to, let me delete this slide. So what will happen when you will export this presentation as a video? So if we talk about the first slide, then it will record the first slide for the transition timing that you will apply. Let's say I want the first slide to run for 10 seconds. Then when you will export this presentation to a video by clicking on File, Export, Create a Video in 2013, 16 and 19, then it will make a video of 10 seconds for the first slide. And for the second slide, it has only one loop and the ending duration is 4.8 seconds. So the total duration of the video will be around 14 seconds. So if you want to make a loop of these animations, then you can add more duplicate slide of the same. Let's say I am adding 3 slides of the same animation, so the total duration will be 4.80 into 3, around maybe 15 or 16 seconds. So if you will now export the video, then it will be around 25 or 26 seconds. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.